Formnext is always full of surprises, but this year, a few launches generally blindsided us. We tracked down 5 announcements you should know about. Welcome back to 3D Natives. I'm Elliot. We've been running all over the halls, booth after booth, demo after demo. And Formnext 2025 is absolutely packed with new machines, software, and technologies. But out of everything we saw, 5 launches truly stood out. Whether it's breakthrough performance, next level automation, or unexpected moves from major players, these are the releases you'll want to keep an eye on. Let's jump right in. Bambu Lab came out swinging with one of the most advanced FDM multi-material systems we've seen. The H2C introduces the new Vortex hot end change system, supporting 6 smart hot ends and up to 24 filaments at once. The magic is in the automation: intelligent material assignment, onboard memory for each hot end, touchless calibration, purge-free or near-purge-free workflow, and a full suite of cameras watching every step. The hot end heats up in just 8 seconds, and the contactless tool change mechanism delivers micrometer level repeatability. Combined with its high power servo extruder and heated chamber, this is the closest we've seen to industrial multi-material capability inside a consumer-friendly ecosystem. Bambu didn't just improve multi-material printing, they reinvented the workflow. Materialise made one of the biggest software announcements of Formnext 2025, with a major expansion of its CO-AM ecosystem, now built around 3 tailored solutions and a powerful new automation layer. The new CO-AM Professional, NPI and Enterprise solutions are all powered by CO-AM Rex, a low-code, node-based automation technology that taps into more than 800 Materialise algorithms from Magix, Build Processor and 3Matic. It's essentially a flexible automation engine that lets users design or customize their workflow visually. Materialise also introduced the CO-AM build platform, a cloud-based build editor that becomes a single source of truth, fully compatible with Magix and even third-party build prep tools. On top of that, the next-gen build processor framework is now fully open and modular, allowing manufacturers to integrate OEM build processors or create their own, and deploy strategies directly through Magix, 3MF workflows or CO-AM. Together, these upgrades make CO-AM a complete and open platform for additive manufacturing, from build prep and automation to validation, execution, and multi-site production. XJet returned with a new addition to its nanoparticle jetting platform, the Carmel PRO. This new printer is not only more affordable and accessible, but it uses the same tried and true technology XJet is known for, whilst adding more capabilities, now handling up to 4 materials at once, the double of the other systems currently in the lineup. For applications like medical devices, jewelry, and precision industrial parts, Carmel PRO pushes XJet firmly back into the spotlight. EOS made one of the most significant metal AM announcements with the new M4 ONYX. This 6 laser systems offer a 450x450x400mm build volume and claims up to 50% higher throughput with 30% lower part cost. Powder recovery exceeds 90% thanks to a completely reworked powder management system. You also get automated job changeovers under 30 minutes, the new RFS Pro filtration system that reduces hazardous waste by up to 90%, advanced monitoring, error detection, and digital fingerprinting for Q&A. Plus, Smart Fusion reduces support requirements, helping cut material and time. The M4 ONYX isn't just an upgrade, it's clearly built for full-scale serial production. This one took everyone by surprise. HP officially jumped into high-performance FDM, and they are clearly aiming at industrial users from day one. The machine introduces closed-loop thermal control for rock-solid dimensional accuracy, a huge challenge in large-format extrusion. HP also went heavy on automation, integrated material handling, optional auto-change extruders, and an interface that brings the familiarity of multi-jet fusion into filament printing. It supports engineering polymers at impressive throughput levels, positioning HP as a serious contender for industrial prototyping and small batch production. This isn't just another FDM machine, it's HP stepping into an entirely new segment with big ambitions. And that wraps up our favorite launches at Formnext 2025. It's been an intense day and we've only scratched the surface. There are many more innovations still to cover. Next up, we're diving into the giants of the show with big printers. Make sure you don't miss it, and until then, happy printing.